en film. Claro.
All I was here to do was to make Xanadu happen.
I don't get it.
Sonny, you have to believe me when I tell you that I never wanted to hurt you.
It's open. The last thing I wanted to happen. It's open!
Not as I appear to you. The expression of his spine on this.
When I left this house approximately 24 hours ago, you were watching the movie Xanadu. You are still watching the movie Xanadu. This frightens me.
Molly, I just ended a 7-year relationship. I feel I have the right to spend a couple of days watching Olivia Newton-John as a singing, dancing, roller skating muse from Mount Olympus.
Okay. Actually, been a real friend during all this.
That won't last. It's only a matter of time before he makes his move.
Molly. Ed is not gonna ask me out. He knows better.
For weeks, the only thing standing between me and Carol Vesey is a boyfriend. Now, if she breaks up with a boyfriend, where am I? With this smiling goat trying to pick up women.
Eddie, trust me, I'm a woman. I know about these things. Now is not the time to make the move on Carol Vesey.
Okay. All right, I'll wait. For the time being.
Ed, $10 if you go over there and you ask that cute blonde if you can buy her a drink.
That's all you got?
With these beer nuts in your mouth.
Oh, excuse me. I'll buy you a drink.
When we fly around, he goes,
Elmo's an airplane.
Introducing Let's Pretend Elmo. Change Elmo's position and he pretends something else.
Elmo's a race car driver.
And do you know what else? Elmo pretends 10 different things. My favorite is
Elmo's a big, hairy monster.
Imagine all that.
It's Super Elmo.
From Sesame Street.
Vote for me. My dad was president. I even look like my dad.
Big deal. My dad was a senator. Yep.
How are we today?
Well, since you asked.
Oh no, you ran into Nick.
Not yet. But here's the thing, Molly. I have to go by his classroom every day after third period in order to get to the cafeteria, and he knows exactly when to expect me, and he always looks up and gives me a wink. You know, it's our little ritual.
So you'd have to go all the way around the building just to avoid his classroom.
Yes, and just thinking about it makes me feel sick.
So don't do it.
You're right. You're right. I can't imagine Nick changing his route to avoid me.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Good for you.
You're right.
Hello, ladies.
Well, hello, Godfrey.
So, Carol, I understand you and Nick have gone your separate ways.
Yeah, we have.
Well, as a history teacher, I find I spend most of my time looking at the past. But right now, I see a future for me and you.
Godfrey, that is so flattering. Really, it is. But I've had to swear off dating people at work, you know?
Oh. Well, if you change your mind, I'll be right down the hall.
Thanks, Godfrey.
Today, Godfrey Blankman. Tomorrow, Ed Stevens.
Molly, stop.
So what can I do for you folks?
Chuck and I are supposed to get married this Saturday.
Oh, congratulations.
But now we have to cancel the wedding. Show him, honey.
Oh, my.
Well, I brought a picture to my hairdresser of Martha Stewart, and I asked for the Martha cut.
This is not the Martha cut.
No. This hairdresser, did she by any chance have any reason to, hate you?
Not that I know of.
She was always perfectly friendly to me.
Look, Mr. Stevens, Chuck and I don't have a lot of money, and postponing this wedding is going to cost us thousands.
You'd like to sue?
All we want is what's fair.
Well, it sounds to me like you do deserve some compensation. In fact, you might even have a case against Martha Stewart. I'm kidding.
Oh.
All right, young scholars. Your day of reckoning has come. You will spend the next hour answering 5 essay questions on the Canterbury Tales. The test will count for 20% of your midterm grade. That is, unless I throw it in the garbage and give you all A's, which I will do under one condition.
What's that, Mr. Stanton?
One of you must say something that moves me, that makes me feel something, anything, I don't care. Make me sad, make me happy, piss me off. A word, a sentence, a speech, the choice is yours. Just as long as you move me. Any takers, or should I start passing out the tests? Yes, Jessica.
My parents got divorced last year. Ever since then, they've been fighting over me like I'm the car or the house, just another possession. I don't think they know what they're doing to me. Or maybe they just don't care.
No, I'm sorry, Jessica. I'm sure your pain is very real, but it's all just a little too familiar. You're gonna have to dig deeper.
Okay, now, everybody. Now, since I bought this bowling alley, we have turned it into what I believe is Stuckeyville's premier amusement destination. However, we're still not getting as many customers as I would like. So what we need to do is put the word out there that Stucky Bowl is the place to be. Any ideas? Yes, Phil.
Nature's billboard, baby.
Translation, please.
Skywriting. Just imagine Stucky Bowl etched across the heavens. Sends chills down my spine.
Actually, that's not a bad idea. I just think we need...
Well, come on, Bosco. I know a guy out at the airfield, Jack Fundus, best in the business.
What makes him the best in the business?
The dude crosses his Z's.
Right. Well, I just think we need something a little less temporary, you know? Yes, Shirley.
You weren't supposed to call on me.
Then why'd you raise your hand?
In school, if people raised their hands, a teacher thought they knew the answer, so they would call on someone else who wasn't raising their hand.
Gotcha. Yes, Kenny.
We should get that Where's the Beef lady. She was hilarious. No matter how many times she asked, she never found out where the beef was.
That's so true, man. The location of the beef was always kept a mystery. Well observed, Kenneth. Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
Actually, that does give me an idea, though. We could just rent some cheap commercial time in a local TV station, right?
Okay, I'll do it. But I demand final cut.
You'll do what?
I'll direct the commercial.
Phil, you're not a director.
Ed, as the great Jean Renoir once said, I am not a director, I am a storyteller. The only thing I bring to this illogical, irresponsible, and cruel universe is my love.
Yes, Shirley.
Please stop calling on me.
Hey, Cal.
Hey.
Hi,
I'm just going to meet Molly for lunch.
Oh, great. I'm on the way to the hairdresser.
Perm, highlights. Yeah,
both. Yeah. No, I have a client who's suing your hairdresser, actually.
I have often wanted to do that.
So how you doing? How are you holding up, you know, post-Nick?
Good. You know, okay. Bad. Actually, I'd have to say I'm kind of bad.
Oh. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. You know, it's funny, you know, the humans, we're fully evolved. You know, we get the big brains and the opposable thumbs, and we still have no idea how to get over a breakup.
I would gladly trade the opposable thumbs. Frankly, I think they're highly overrated.
But, you know what I think the key is, Carol? Keep moving forward.
Yeah, yeah. What'd you think?
Well, they were, you know, they were good.
Yeah, but
Why? How? Let's talk about the characters, the symbolism, Jake Barnes, Robert Cohen, Spain.
Spain, yeah. Well, I believe that Ernest Hemingway was trying to tell us that the sun, in addition to setting,
All New Ed, next Sunday on NBC.
Where's the best place to take your kids each night? Your lap. So sit your kids down and read to them.